Indeed, guys, it's impressive. You know, I remember being roughly 30 years in this group. And when I hear my colleagues and I start from LIFE, the implementation we are doing in LIFE in Slovakia now and Austria to scale up the German product in those countries, something unthinkable some years ago. The Allianz customer model with Klaus Peter Eller and Ivan, implementation of a concrete way of running the business, identical in the countries, and I will go through that later, is also quite of an innovative approach. And then the micro SME concept, which is also deployed as a pilot through Austria and then scaling up those activities in the countries, I would clearly say this makes a community of countries where I would say honestly we feel the pride of being part of it and delivering in a very concrete way in the context of the renewal agenda. And our region is a true example of transformation where the applicability of the concept of the renewal agenda is very much visible, not only conceptually but also through the results. I would like to drive you through this I would call it, quite impressive, if you allow me the wording, journey the last 3 years since the beginning 2015, and then the outlook, the way ahead until 2021. We are talking about 11 countries that have been managed in a scattered way for quite a few years, and we have put together this organization in the last 3 years since 2015. 4.4 billion revenues, 491 million operating profit, 8.3 million customers with an ROE of 14% and RMPS above market 75% of the communities. Those are the numbers that reflect the achievements of 2017. And since the outlook and the expectation the way ahead is also quite impressive, somebody could say, okay, and the starting point is weak, and therefore the improvement is significant. I want to remind you that the starting point of this journey is already in 2014, where this community of countries was performing 350 million euros operating profit. So already 2017, we were 40% above the starting point 3 years ago. And then we commit an additional 45% improvement of operating profitability at the horizon of 2021, combined with an improvement of our revenues, of our top line of 25%. We expect to achieve an overall customer base of close to 10 million, with a starting point of 8.3 million today. And then ROE 14 plus 3, it makes 17%. I would say a quite interesting ROE from an investor's perspective. And this is done, and I want to be very clear on that. It's not only a numbers-driven exercise. There are 11 different communities, diverse countries, different aspirations per country, different degree of maturity on what insurance is about, different degree of financial literacy of the customers, and therefore, putting those 11 countries together represents, I would say, a quite interesting challenge. It's like a micrography of what the Allianz Group is about in a global scale. I want to go through, not very much in detail, but on the large picture of what has been achieved up till now and what is the expectation the way ahead. And then I would clearly distinguish our activities, the last 3 years, in two categories, in two different distinctive chapters. The first one is what we call outperform. It was characterized by what we have been undertaking the last 3 years, and then the true transformation, the way ahead, with the Allianz customer model being at the epicenter of our priorities, the way ahead. Looking backwards, 2015 to 17, and then I would try to use a rather provocative example in your eyes to make this a little bit more clear, because sometimes people, when they see productivity improvement or performance culture or complexity reduction, they can imagine a variety of things behind those buzzwords. I could take the example of this session today, the investor discussion and the presentation of today. And let's assume that there are 20 people preparing this room. There are some people that are working on the acoustics, on what we see, the visuals, but also on the setup of the room, the tables, the chairs, the plugs you have close to your seats. So this setup has been finalized by a team of 20 people. And let's now go backwards and say that in a country like the ones we represent in the region, this has been done before 2015 by a variety of ways with 40, 50, 60 people, and with a similar probably outcome of the exercise, but with different ways and different rhythms of productivity. What we have been doing between 2015 and 17 is to try to identify that there is a benchmark, there is a best practice, there is a benchmark of 20 people doing this activity, and then we have tried to assess the distance of each and every country towards the benchmark. This hasn't been done centrally and instructively. It has been done in a rather collaborative way. And then the local entities, the local units, have come to us with their own ambition level for each and every setup. So if in each and every country we would have had the opportunity to build a community like the one we have today here, each country would have committed to do it with 25, 30 people or 32 people, a different point than the one they had as a starting one in their mindset. And this is what the outperformance kind of category of homework is about. It is what I call a hygiene exercise of understanding primarily whether the resources we allocate on certain activities are really the right ones and whether we truly drive complexity reduction in the right sense. Overarching principle of this lever, and I want to make this very clear to you, is first of all the quality of people, the understanding of the local communities of undertaking this exercise properly is not something instructive. We cannot do it through Munich. We have to have locally the right resources and the right mindset. And then clearly our ambition, and it's only reflected in the numbers we have achieved. You will see it also in the outlook in the last page. It is clearly the ambition we have to be outperforming distinctively different than the other components of the group. We have clearly an ambition as a region to show that we can make the difference. And this is something I would say that conceptually is embraced by the entire community of our region. And then transformation. Transformation is relevant primarily to the Allianz customer model, to the way we intend to run the business in a more simple and a more agile way, through simplicity, customer centricity, and then regional business model, which would allow us at the end of the day to achieve an operating environment of one legal entity. It's like we are having in 11 countries one unit operationalizing our activities within the communities. Simplicity and harmony. And here I want to make the difference to what Klaus Peter was mentioning earlier, because it is indeed different to manage a context of a large country or a smaller one standalone. And there indeed we are talking about business model transformation and production line that would allow you to support properly the requirements you have set at market level. But then if you have 11 countries to manage in the same context, you need definitely a steering mechanism, a governance model, a certain components of the culture you implement into the community that would allow you comfortably to run this activity the way ahead. It's not simple, it's not easy. Believe me, sometimes the excitement on the effort is much stronger than the reality of things that are happening and that they can happen. I would take the example that is my preferred one from the cultural bucket, job mirroring and mobility. And here again, I will refer to the previous example of this room. So The transformational journey we're undertaking now goes beyond to the ambition of having 25 or 30 people preparing this conference of today. Our ambition now is to create exact mirroring tasks in every working position. So the guy who is setting up the tables has to do exactly the same job in each and every country. The person, the specialist who is specialized on acoustics, he or she should be activating him or herself in the same exact way to make sure that the delivery is outstanding and it meets the expectations of the audience. So this kind of mirroring the activities, it creates a more, I would call it, industrialized approach on servicing internally through our human resources, our customers, but it definitely creates a certain degree of comfort because also it's not about having the same characteristics in every job, but primarily creating a certain element of mobility that accelerates this community building. So we have people that are intending to move from one country to another to service those activities, and I think this is amazingly powerful. So we break, I would say, to a certain extent, the traditional barriers between the countries by making people working together in a closer way than this has been encountered through the past. A typical example, and I don't want to exhaust you, I think you have heard and seen a lot today about a simplicity call, and this is again a pure reflection of the Allianz customer model, the way it has been implemented in the region. The second set of column where you see motor product and you have those four alternatives, it is the exact same product you will have from the end of first quarter next year in all the countries of the region. This is going to be the motor product, as simple as that, as visible, as clear as it is in this picture. Four packages that are reflecting the exact needs of the community. People are thinking many times that, you know, we play the role of the expert and we define the packages. This hasn't been done this way, and I want to make it clear. 5,000 people were part of an exhaustive market research. 32 focus groups with 250 participants where we checked the exact components of the package to make sure that not only the communities accept the solution, but they also appreciate, they enjoy that this is the right thing to do. So I would clearly say that this is the outcome of a market-driven approach on designing, defining, and implementing products. And then, you know, four products instead of 1,000 coverage and combinations, this is also impressive because we tend to underestimate. If I ask you, how would you depict a typical motor product, you could give me your flavor and I'm sure it's going to be more or less quite homogeneous. But if you go in each and every single corner of our countries, you could realize, for example, that in one of our countries, we have a cover for motorcycle clothing. So an add-on to a motor policy for a motorcycle clothing cover, which means that if the car hits a motorbike rider and the rider is wearing valuable clothes, he has the right to collect a compensation at the value of his clothing. This cover was sold in 43 pieces in the specific country. So we have 43 clients that have bought this cover. And this cover has been there for the last 3 years, stable, not moving at all, without any either appetite to increase penetration, because evidently there is not much of a community of this specific clientele, and therefore the degree of complexity that this example generates, if you magnify it to 1,000 covers, which were the ones we identified as being relevant in the countries, you can understand the challenges we are facing and the importance of implementing properly the Allianz customer model. And then on the right, I think it was also mentioned earlier in the context of the implementation in Germany, we are indeed focusing on servicing the claimants as well with a common customer journey that would allow them to go from notification till ready to go with the clarity of an application where we can follow up all the steps of the policy. Scalability of the business model, more than evident. I would focus in a few words on two things. One, Austria and Russia have been integrated in our region since the beginning of this year. So last quarter of last year, and then part of our plans and our numbers beginning of this year. I can tell you the speed and the properness of implementing the regional agenda within Austria and Russia gives us also the comfort to claim that the scalability of the business model is really there already, is already done, and we know how it can work. And this is relevant not only to internal candidates, but I would say also primarily to external potential activities that would allow us to scale up our businesses. We are now exploiting the opportunity of Slovenia, and we are working on Slovenia on a simplified product value proposition. We are selling in Slovenia only the simplified products, motor and property, and this is done through a branch office from the Croatian activities. And we are also exploring the opportunity of stepping into the Baltics through a branch office again from the Polish activities. It's going to be part of our preparatory work for next year for the strategic dialogue. So I would clearly say the scalability of the business model is already there, and it makes a lot of sense to undertake all the necessary actions and collect as much activity as we can afford to make this happen. I would close my presentation with this page, which is really a trivial one, and it reflects our plans and our numbers. And I want to make sure that we understand that in our community, 700 million profitability, which is doubling the profits from 2014, and it gives a CAGR of growth of OP of roughly 10% per year, is something already there, stamped and committed from our organization. Our internal ambition is to reach 1 billion euros. And I'm telling you this very bluntly, the region should go to 1 billion euros. We have the right to do it. We have the right way of running our businesses that would allow us to scale up our activities the way ahead. And this ambition clearly drives our expectation of improvement and higher penetration in those markets. This is not only, as I said earlier, a numbers exercise, it is a people exercise. It has to do with the right attitude. We are greedy in making more and allocating properly our resources in this effort. And I think clearly the community we are building around the countries would allow us to comfortably undertake this challenge. Thank you very much for your attention.